this today was about exploring. We got to actually demonstrate the autonomous vehicle, the auto weed spray rig. I think it's good for farmers to see new tech, things that are happening. It is here, it's here and now, it's happening. It's all about trying to improve their lifestyle, improve their profitability and their productivity. If you've got a machine that can run day and night and do the job that you're normally sitting on or someone else is sitting on, that's a massive benefit. It's also a benefit in the fact like the weather. For example, if this machine ran all night last night and finished that paddock's now ready to do whatever it needs to do next time, and it rained today, you've got it done. Otherwise, you've gone home, gone to bed, wake up in the morning, and the paddock's not done.
AutoWeed, that's a company that we've developed based in Townsville, and we develop green-on-green spraying technology that detects weeds and rejects background plant life in order to lower herbicide costs for growers and reduce the herbicide usage for the industry. We use artificial intelligence-based detection. So AI uses human annotated data sets or imagery to detect weeds based on color, shape, and texture. So the same features your eyes would use to detect the weeds is what we're using with our AI-based algorithms. We basically mount a camera in between the tractor and the spray boom of existing machinery, and that camera acts as an eye to detect the weed if it's existing and tell the sprayer to turn on as the vehicle's passing over the crop. And so that basically allows it to, you know, not spray the whole paddock, but only spray a portion of the paddock with how much weed density you have. So you're saving as much herbicide as you have weeds. It's a win-win for growers and for the environment with lowering input costs. So if you're in our trial cases, we've been able to show that spot spraying works as well as blanket spraying, up to 95%, while reducing herbicide usage by 35%. So that's 35% money saved in your pocket, not spent on herbicide. As part of our project with the Great Barrier Reef Foundation, partnering with SRA, JCU, and DAF, we've been able to perform 9 trials of this technology across the Burdekin region. Some of those trials worked really well, getting up to 100% result compared to blanket spraying. We had one drop in performance on a trial due to shadow variation. So if we collect data in sunlight and then the day of trial it's overcast, the camera didn't perform as well. So to combat this, we've added some LEDs to actually allow the robot to see during all conditions. We're also hopeful that if we connect it up data, it'll have enough robustness against all different seasonal changes and weather environments.
It's impressive stuff. I've had a look at this before when they've had a demo day at Bowen, and also we've had AutoWeed on my farm doing trials. So impressive equipment. If we could couple the robotic automated tractor to the AutoWeed, it would make a huge savings in, as far as use of chemical, and when it comes to controlling, you know, sort of spot weeds or even just going through the paddock and controlling any problem grasses and weeds we've got through the paddock where you don't have to actually blanket spray the whole block. The advantage going forward with this technology would be the fact that you don't have to have someone sitting on there applying the chemical. Once it's set up and let it go, it's technology we're looking at in the future.
Today was very special because this is the first time we've proven that this technology can detect 2 weeds at once using 2 different tanks. So it's kind of a Burdekin's first, world's first, you might call it, to spray 2 weeds at once with the same green on green technology. So the feedback was great. We're very excited ourselves to be delivering this tech in partnership with SRA. It's just been tremendous. So as I mentioned, this is the first dual tank sprayer that we've got. That means there's 2 tanks and 2 spray lines. So we've got a blue line and a red line. And we've basically got our detection units with the camera at the front here. At the front. So each one of those looks at 1 sugarcane row each, and that's where the decision is being made to detect a weed and activate the sprayers. So for this trial, we targeted broadleaf weeds and grass weeds, and we've set up the nozzles so that the red nozzle targets grass and the blue nozzle targeted broadleaf, and we ran at about 8 kilometers an hour. And this is the setup that we'll be using for the rest of our trials. Basically, we can detect any weed in the target crop. We've, so far in our trial work, targeted nut grass, summer grass. We've targeted broadleaves in a mung bean crop, broadleaves in a ratoon cane plot, nut grass in a plant cane crop. You can basically target a variety of weeds. This is the first time that we've targeted 2 different ones at once, and that introduces labor savings so that you would only have to pass the field once and you can spray 2 different applications. But yeah, you can also tweak this to be detecting the cane rather than the weeds. And in that scenario, you're kind of mapping your crop health potentially. This is a potential use case. We're not doing that for the project, but that is a potential use case that AI images in the field could allow. That's why another good reason this field trip today was fantastic, this demonstration, because we also saw a fully autonomous robotic solution. And that is the dream, fully autonomous sprayers and implements working so that you don't have to pay a driver to do it and you have more time to do other things as a grower.
I reckon it's been a very excellent and interesting day today. Learning and seeing new technology is a great thing to see. We've got to move on, we've got to step with the future and accept what's coming, I think, and if it helps us in any way, it's perfect.
It's important for SRA to be on the front foot, and when we talk about technology and Sugar Research Australia, that's what we do. So it's great for us to be able to promote this type of activity.